So Carl has been talking about correlations and relationships between the independent variable and the dependent variable. I would assume that most of you in this lecture hall have had some experience talking about independent variables and dependent variables and the causality link. We don't have time in this particular class, it's a one credit seminar, to go through the details and the sort of the mechanics of calculating these correlation coefficients. I think it's incredibly useful to do that. And I would say probably most of you have done that. But I'm going to assume nothing here. And we're going to try to teach, at least since we're going to talk about this, teach just through visual representation what a correlation coefficient really is. So this is a standard plot that you would see in a lot of textbooks. It's also found, you'd find this on Wikipedia or any sort of explanatory board for explaining correlation coefficients visually. But what I want to ask you, just to sort of do in your head, we're not going to do this as a poll everywhere, but it's a really important exercise. This is a, like, it's one of those skills that you can't, again, you can't, there's certain things you can't leave with UW without knowing, and this is one of, you know, I would say a dozen things. So right up here on the left, what would be the correlation value? And I'll remind you that they go from -1 to 1. So the one on the left, just put it in your head, what would you expect the one on the left? So you have the independent variable and the dependent variable are going up in a common pattern, and it's done very tightly. So what would you expect that sort of number to be? 1, right? All right, so what would you expect this one that's just almost, it's the mirror image of that particular relationship we have here on the right. So what I'm pointing to right here is this one. I'm doing this very easily for some of you. You've seen this so many times. You knew this when you were in junior high, if you were studying these. But it's something to be reminded of. Do we want to be able to understand these things? So this one is, of course, -1.
That's weird. Why is it -1?
Yeah, why is it -1?
I mean, one variable is perfectly predicting the other. It sounds like it should be 1 to me.
Yeah. Why is it -1? Who wants to answer that?
Because as the independent variable increases, the dependent variable is decreasing. So it's -1 to 1 would be like the slope of the line that you would draw from it.
That's right. So do these sort of brain exercises anytime you've seen plots about the relationship and the direction in which they're going. So excellent. Good. Now what do we have for the middle one? So what I want you to do now is tell me, actually we could even start with this one. Tell me, this one's a little more complicated. Can anyone, without looking at the answer, if you've seen these before, what's the number? Just put it in your head. Think for just a second. Anyone want to shoot out a number if they promise of not to see the answer? Give me a number. 0.75. Not a bad guess. That's pretty good. -0.75. Yes. Good. All right. We got learning going on. This is great. All right. Perfect. Well, one more guess, since we got to have like a little guess range. 6.7, all right. So we got 0.75 and 6.7. Okay, so let's see what it is. -8. Good job. Very. That's just by thinking about what those values are, you're going to be comfortable with these. So I would imagine you would all guess that this would 0.8. Now let's do the middle ones. What are the middle ones? 0.5, 0.4, what else? 0.3. Okay, this is easy for you. Okay, all right, you guys are right on. Okay, what about these relationships though? How do the values change for these? Which ones, how do they vary? How would the answers for this second row change given the relationships that you see between the independent variable and the variable and the directions in which they're going? How would they change? They're all the same, except there's symmetrical, except for the middle one, which is 0. All right. We did say here visualizing linear relationships, but let's look at a couple nonlinear ones. Here's my question to you, and then we can move on to some of these fun examples that we've put together. You have A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Which one of those, I'll tell you that a lot of them are 0. Which one of those are not 0? Just think in your head. You don't have to give me an answer. I'll let you think for a second. Which ones are not 0?
Don't trust them.
They're all 0. Here's the
not
key
cool,
here.
Dude.
I know. Pretty soon by the end, they will be doing jokes on me instead. Visualizing linear relationships. So we're talking about linear relationships. A sine wave, if you have points that land perfectly on a sine wave, will be highly correlated. But that's a different kind of relationship. Okay? So just have that's your sort of one kind of tiny bit of lesson today. And now let's start to apply these to kind of more real-world examples.